Hi viewers, welcome to my channel Blood Test. It is so encouraging and welcoming to see so many subscribers for my channel, and we are responding to all your comments. If we have missed any of you, kindly wait, we'll definitely get back to you soon. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, kindly subscribe it now so that you can know when I upload my next videos, and also share our channel. Coming to the topic, I have already said that I'll be talking about staffing. See, staffing plays a major role in a laboratory. So we divide the laboratories into small, medium, and large laboratory. And we have various duties and responsibilities in each type of laboratory. So coming to the small laboratory, the duties to be fulfilled are the reception area, the phlebotomy, and the housekeeping area. So in a reception area, you need to appoint a person who is very kind and polite enough. This person needs to have basic computer knowledge. He needs to register the patients, and once the report is ready, needs to dispatch the reports, take the printout and give it to the patient. This is the duty. Next comes the phlebotomy. For a small sized laboratory, it is enough if you take an assistant nursing staff, or you can take a junior technician who has completed his DMLT course. This person needs to have a good experience in withdrawing blood from the patient. And then comes the housekeeping. In either of the small, medium, or large laboratory, housekeeping plays a major role. Okay, so in every healthcare business, cleanliness is one important thing we need to take care for our patients to walk in again and again. So make sure every other day, every single day of your laboratory is clean, as well as your bathroom is cleaned every day, and the outside premises is also kept clean every day. Coming to the medium-sized laboratory, again, the duties to be here fulfilled are the reception area, the phlebotomy, housekeeping. And one major thing we need to see in a medium-sized laboratory is we need to run simple blood tests like sugars and also urine samples. So here, again, for the reception, you need to have a person. For the phlebotomy here, what I suggest is you can have a DMLT technician who has had minimum of 2 years experience who can also run samples. So two duties or two responsibilities can be fulfilled with one person. He can also withdraw blood. He can also run simple blood samples, and a housekeeping person. This is all you need in a medium-sized laboratory. Coming to the large laboratory. A large laboratory is a referral laboratory. You have invested a lot on automated machines. So what is the one most important thing? You need to have a lot of walk-in customers, and you also need to run very advanced tests in your laboratory. So one major thing you need to see here is the reception person whom you're appointing is must be very, very capable of convincing your patients to take the blood test, and also has to be kind and polite, needs to have good computer knowledge because he has to access mails for the reports, he has to send them. This person also needs to follow up patients for again and again to visit your laboratory. And this reception person will be talking to doctors, to clinicians and all. So from where all do you get samples for a large laboratory? From hospitals, from clinics, and from other laboratories. So you have three major sources from where you get samples here. So here, a technician must be very, very strong. Here, you put a separate reception person. You put a junior technician or a separate assistant nursing staff for the phlebotomy. You keep an in-house full-time housekeeping. For these two, if it is enough, if a person comes, visits your laboratory, cleans it up and goes. But in a large laboratory, an in-house housekeeping person needs to be there all the time, round the clock for your laboratory. And the senior technician plays a major role here, because he needs to have minimum of 4 to 5 years of experience in running all the fully automated machines, and also is capable of troubleshooting if any problems comes in the automated machine. So you would have 4 persons in this laboratory. Apart from all these persons, 1 to 3 or 4 persons in a small, medium or large laboratory, all the patients, all the customers of you want to take blood test at the convenience or the comfort of their home. So one major person for any type of laboratory you need to appoint is a home collection person. So for a home collection person, it can either be an assistant nursing staff or a junior technician. This person goes exclusively to the home, collects blood samples or urine samples and brings it to your laboratory. Apart from this, for a medium and large laboratory, you need an in-house pathologist. For a medium-sized laboratory, the pathologist can be a visiting junior pathologist. In a large laboratory, you need, if you're not able to afford a senior pathologist, at least a junior pathologist should be there so that all your processes of your laboratory are overlooked and quality is maintained. When the quality of your laboratory is maintained, people will definitely know it is there and trust builds upon your laboratory and thereby your business grows. So this is about the laboratory business. If you have any comments or any queries, kindly write to us. We are there to help you out. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, kindly subscribe it. Thank you and see you tomorrow with another video.